So should we go starting? And
I think the response has been fairly good here at the Capitol, because there's a lot of young people who come by, and high school students, college students are very receptive to this message, more so than older people. Although there are quite a few older people who understand the issue too. I spoke with a woman a couple of days ago, and said a lot of parents are saying no to circumcision and really understand this issue. And she says, well, how about grandmothers too? So, March 30th is the anniversary of when it became illegal to circumcise girls in the United States. And we believe boys deserve equal protection. That male circumcision is medically unnecessary. So it's really just a form of permanent body modification. It's like tattoos or body piercing. So when a boy is old enough to get a tattoo, or when he's old enough to get a body piercing, then he can decide whether or not he wants to be circumcised. I think the main message that we need to present is on this sign here. Circumcision is unnecessary and harmful. When people accept circumcision as the cultural norm, the first thing that they have to buy into is the idea or the fact that circumcision is unnecessary. And then once they realize and accept that it's unnecessary, then they're ready to move to the next step, which is circumcision is harmful. When they realize it's harmful, then they're ready to start thinking about the human rights issues. And if you start out with a message about human rights, a lot of people just aren't ready for that. You gotta start out with something that they're willing to accept, which is circumcision is unnecessary.